Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to American Truck Simulator. My name is Moose78. Hope you guys are doing well today, by the way. We are finally back here in ATS, back in the 680. Got this load of panels going over to Elko, Nevada. Should be a nice little quick run for us. We are here in Truckee, California. And I want to mix it up a little bit and kind of get up into northern Nevada, northern California a little bit more than I have been here lately. Kind of feels like I've been hitting Arizona and southern California pretty hard. So kind of want to mix it up a little bit, and I'm sure as most of you guys have heard by now, New Mexico is going to be the next state for ATS. Of course, no timetable for the release of that, but they updated the blog post on the day of the one-year anniversary, letting everyone know officially that New Mexico was going to be the next state, which we all kind of knew that was coming. You know, I know I've seen it on a couple different forums and just, you know, kind of through the grapevine and stuff that New Mexico was indeed going to be next. And I guess that's okay, but I know me personally, I'm ready for more of this, you know, northern Pacific Northwest type scenery. You know, the mountains, the trees, stuff like that. Kind of mix it up a little bit. Because I'm sure as a lot of you guys did, and as I did as well, back in the Holland days, you probably played the Cali map from Ivan quite a bit, so I've definitely had my fair share of Southern California and desert scenery there. But will be nice to get another state in game, make some runs from you know, Northern California all the way to you know, the southeast corner of Mexico. So that'll be kind of nice. Get some longer runs in, for sure. But yeah, the uploads have been pretty sparse here lately, and I do apologize for that. But hopefully we can get back on track here. Things just have been a little bit crazy. Been working quite a bit behind the scenes on getting some stuff set up for live streaming. I believe I am pretty much ready to go on that. Now, I know initially said I was just going to do YouTube, but I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to do both Twitch and YouTube. Not sure if I'll do them both at the same time, because there is a service out there that will allow you to stream to multiple different platforms simultaneously, but not sure if I'm going to do that yet or not. But definitely want to get over on Twitch and kind of stream over there a little bit. And I'll stream ATS over there, of course, but I'll also be streaming, you know, the Division, Ghost Recon Wildlands, once that comes out. Probably a couple other games as well. And I'll probably do the same thing over on YouTube, just kind of mix it up a little bit, but YouTube will definitely primarily be when I stream here, will be, you know, ATS, since that is what most of you guys are here for. Tried to get a video out the other day, but I had a bit of a brain fart there, and you know, while I was getting all the stream stuff set up, I had to uninstall and reinstall some stuff. And when I sat down to record the other day, I forgot to go back and redo my settings at OBS, so I was recording the video, but no audio. So, smooth move on my part. But we're back today, and like I said, we're gonna try to get back on track here. I know I was doing pretty good there for the first few weeks of the year, getting the five days a week upload thing going. Seemed like that was going pretty well. You guys were watching them, checking them out, supporting, things like that. So I definitely want to get back to doing that. Channel continues to grow, closing in on 900 subs. I'm going to be knocking on the door for 1,000. Pretty excited about that. Taking out DP's traffic mod. Come on, seriously? Just because of stuff like that. And the AI is unpredictable on its own without any kind of modifications. And just with the way the AI's been behaving since the update, that traffic mod was a little bit more than you know, I kind of cared to handle there. It just the unpredictable drops in speeds. Just just do not understand it. I mean, the thing there on the HUD says 80 mile an hour, but you know, we're dropping down quite a few, 20 miles an hour there or better. So I'm not sure why that is, but I wouldn't mind to get that mod back in because I really enjoyed it, especially in city driving, because it really did kind of give it more of an immersive, realistic feel. It's just out here on the highway, there was just too many times I would get brake checked and stuff like that. You know, that's still going to happen, but it shouldn't be as bad because the traffic's going to be a little bit lighter. And going through Reno here, I need to slow down just a little bit. They've gotten a little bit better with letting you know, hey, there's reduced speeds ahead, but I think it still could use a little bit of touching up. At least for my taste, it could. But yeah, the one-year anniversary of ATS came and went with, at least in my opinion, without a whole lot of fanfare. I was kind of hoping for a little bit more. I mean, we did get the announcement that, like I said there at the beginning, that New Mexico was going to be the next state. But other than that, that's all we got. And there's the speeding ticket. I do have the MHA Pro map in. They did get that updated, as you can see the billboard up there. They did get that updated for 1.5, so I'm using that. And I'm also using the Realistic California Highways version 1.1, the RCH. I don't have Viva Mexico in yet. I kind of want to see how these two mods behave together, make sure there's no issues or stuff like that. So probably, even though I want to run a little bit of more of the northern part of the map, I'll probably get back down to the southern part here pretty soon just to see if those mods, these two mods, are gonna work well together. And if so, then I'll go ahead and add Viva Mexico as well to get a third map mod in there. But back to the 1 year anniversary, you know, I was kind of hoping for a little bit more than you know, what we got there. You know, maybe something like, hey, here's the 1 year anniversary. Oh, by the way, here's a new truck. Or here's something, you know, to kind of celebrate that 1 year, because it's been a really good first year for ATS. And we got the rescale, which was awesome. You know, the community absolutely loved that. They more than doubled the size of their staff. They started out initially with, I think they said, 8 people, and now they're up to 20 dedicated people working just on ATS. And they're looking to double that this year. So, you know, pretty good first year overall. I think they got the game in a really good state now. And like I've said before, I think they have a really good foundation laid for the game moving forward. And I'm getting my doors blown off by Saya here. That's kind of embarrassing. It's okay though. He can run the front door and get the next ticket. But yeah, that was pretty much all that came out of that blog post was, you know, New Mexico, and they're looking to double the size of the staff. No updates on any trucks, any licensing issues, you know, where they're at on that. So kind of curious to see how year two is going to play out. Going back to an article, way station coming up here. Going back to an, oh, dadgummit, man, we're gonna have to go in. That's all right. But I think they said they were looking to support ATS. I think it was for either 2 or 5 years. I wanna say it was 5 years. If you guys know for sure, leave a comment down below, but I thought it was, you know, they were looking to support the game for 5 years, you know, which we already got 1 year behind us, so because, you know, I'm good at math, we have 4 years left to go. That means they're going to have to do roughly about a state a month to, you know, have all lower 48 states done within that time frame. Which again, I can't remember if that's exactly what it was or not, so, you know, don't quote me on that. That's just kind of my speculation, kind of my assumption there. But, you know, hopefully we get some more content coming out a little bit faster. I think we should. Again, my speculation there. I don't have anything to, you know, go on. But, you know, now, you know, obviously the rescale is done. The, you know, standard has been set for what they want to do moving forward. I would think, at least in terms of, you know, states, I think we should see states flow a little bit better this year. And I think we should see some more states this year other than, you know, like the one or two that we got last year. Now, I still think the game was probably released about a year too early, honestly. I think they should have waited until they had more content done. But nonetheless, I think they finished off 2016 pretty strong, and I think we're starting off 2017, you know, equally as strong with, you know, we're getting a new state here pretty soon. Hopefully we get an open beta coming up here in the next couple weeks. Check out the new map. See if we get any new features or anything like that. Go ahead and get the lights on there. But I definitely think that year two is going to be a pretty crucial year for this game. You know, the modding community has done a phenomenal job of supporting this game. And look out on the Steam Workshop, you know, there's a couple new mods going up every day. There's a couple, you know, mod sites out there outside of the workshop. And of course, you know, I'm sure there's several people that are part of, you know, Facebook groups, things like that, little modding groups that, you know, work on content for the game as well. So the modding community, the modding community is pretty strong for this game. But hopefully in year two, you know, SES can kind of match that a little bit with, you know, some new mods and, you know, hopefully some new trucks and states and things like that as well. You know, if they can do that, I think we'll have a pretty good year two. But it's nice to see the community, you know, constantly growing. That's always a good thing. Overall, I'm just pretty excited to see what year two has to offer for us. Other than that, not a whole lot going on. Just been pretty busy, you know, like I said there at the start, outside of the YouTubes and the hobbies of gaming and all that fun stuff. Now that I got everything set up for streaming, I definitely want to do some stuff with that. Definitely do some daytime streams, maybe in some streams there during the evening or night or whatever, for an hour or two here or there. I think the Division's on PTS number 4 now, so I definitely want to get back into that and check that out. Want to get into some of the Last Stand gameplay, which is, of course, their PvP game mode. It's all PvP. So you guys that play and follow the Division know exactly what I'm talking about there, but it's just a dedicated PvP mode. It takes place in the Dark Zone, 8v8. Looks like a lot of fun. Heard a lot of good things about it, so I definitely want to check that out. And there's, you know, tons of other stuff to do in the Division as well. If you're just someone that, you know, likes the PvE aspect of it, there's a just plethora of stuff to do there. So definitely want to stream that stuff. Wouldn't mind to stream some survival gameplay, because that's a lot of fun. That's a game mode I really do enjoy. I've been playing a lot of the Underground lately as well there in the Division, trying to unlock level 40 so I can get the rewards for that. I think I got like 7 more levels to go, which shouldn't take me, you know, too long, honestly. probably about 10, 12 runs down in the underground, and I should have a level 40 unlocked. Then played the Ghost Recon Wildlands beta this past weekend, and it was fun. I enjoyed it. Just it was poorly optimized here on the PC, though. I mean, just poorly optimized. So I was kind of disappointed in that. That kind of took away from the experience quite a bit. The controls on the vehicles were pretty clunky, pretty herky-jerky. But overall, the gameplay experience, I enjoyed. The story to the game, I enjoyed. I think that's definitely a game I can sit down and play for a little bit. Reminded me quite a bit of Far Cry 4 and the Splinter Cell, the Blacklist. Two games I also enjoyed. Two games I actually need to go back and finish playing. You know, here lately, I've pretty much the only new games that I've got are the ones that I really wanted to get. You know, this, you know, Battlefield 1, The Division. Outside of that, I've, you know, just kind of stopped buying so many new games because I have such a back catalog of stuff that I need to go back and play. I'm definitely glad to have the MHA map back in game. You know, I've used it quite a bit in the past before the rescale. You know, spoke highly of it then, and I'm just really excited to see what they've got to offer in 1.5. You know, one thing you've probably noticed already is, you know, they have quite a few billboards, which kind of liven up the scenery a little bit. Slow down just a little bit here because traffic's kind of doing its thing. See, this is what I'm talking about. You know, the speed limit there says 65, unless I missed a sign. And I could have. Sorry, car. Trying to save lives here. And we slowed all the way down to, like, you know, almost 50 mile an hour there. I know some cars were exiting back there, but... So now the speed limit's back to 80, and everyone's going to be flying past me here in a second. I think the MHA guys do a really good job of adding things to the environment to kind of make it feel a little bit more immersive, a little bit more alive. You know, of course, they add some new cities, companies, things like that as well. So a lot of good stuff in there to explore and check out for sure. And then plus it'd be nice to get down to Southern California and check out what they've done there with the RCH project. See, there's one of the new towns, Battle Mountain. So that's pretty cool. Set the cruise and we're good to go. And of course, we're finally getting some nighttime driving in, which I kind of wanted to do to kind of break the cycle. Because I don't know how I did it, but I got pretty much like on a set schedule in-game where I was, you know, driving during the exact same times and resting during the exact same times. So it's nice to kind of break that up a little bit, get some evening driving in, some nighttime driving in. Because one thing I really enjoy about this game is, you know, like the evening time in the game, because the sunsets usually look pretty amazing. Really makes for some good scenery and some good screenshots. This is a pretty nice run from Truckee over to Elko. Just a straight shot across 80, so that's kind of nice. You know, as the game continues to grow and expand, it'll be nice to run across 80. You know, all the way from, you know, the West Coast to the East Coast and vice versa. That'll be kind of cool. Say we should be coming up on Elko here pretty soon. Go. Now that stays green. Good. I thought I had that fixed where there were no more red textures in game. I'm not sure why that's doing that. No, one of my buddies sent me something there the other day to fix that, and I thought that had taken care of it, but for whatever reason it has not, so I'll have to double check. It's probably something on my end. Probably some kind of mod conflict or something like that. So let me get that checked out. Really? That's number two this trip. No good. No bueno. I'm just around the corner here and you good to go. This thing dropped off and find a place to rest and move on to the next journey. see where they want it. Hopefully nowhere crazy. That shouldn't be too bad. I think I can do that. I think I can. Boy, that other trailer there is not going to help me, though. I'll tell you that much right now. Make it work, though. Too bad to get in there. Let's pull up, straighten up a little bit, and should be good. Good enough for me. That is good enough for me. All right, guys, well, that is going to wrap it up for another episode of Stories from the Road. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If so, just give the video a like and a share. It just helps me out a bunch and helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around, watch a couple videos, and consider subscribing now. And be sure to check out the video description for my streaming information for Twitch as well. Be sure to check that out. But guys, I'm going to cut on out of here to the next video. Stay safe out there. Take care. And we'll be seeing you.